Hello everyone, my name is Cipriano from the University of Milan, and first of all I want to thank all the organizers of TIPES 2022 to let me speak at this conference, and also to all the people who are watching this pre-recorded talk. So please, if you have any comments or questions, you can send me an email to the address that you see on the screen. Well, this talk is titled Omotopy-Setoids and Quotient Completion. And first of all, let's recall what is a setoid. This is a notion of constructive mathematics introduced by Bishop, which consists of a collection of objects equipped with an equality relation. In type theory, independent type theory, it becomes just a pair where we have a closed type X and a dependent type R over X of this form, which is an equivalence relation. Setoids have been widely studied in literature, in particular by Hoffman in his PhD thesis, who proved that they play a fundamental role in the interplay between the extensional and intensional type theory. I recall that a type theory is called extensional when the notion of propositional equality, given by the identity type, coincides with the judgmental equality. Otherwise, it is called intensional. On the left, we have a type theory which has good computational content, such as the type check, the normalization, the canonicity. But this type theory lacks of extensional constructs because they break the good computational contents. Extensional constructs are supported by extensional type theory, and they are used in everyday mathematics. For instance, we have the quotient construction, the functional extensionality, the uniqueness of identity proof. And the work of Hoffman proved that we can, using the so-called setoid model, recover the extensional constructs into intensional type. So, what we did instead was to study a particular class of setoids that we have called homotopy setoids or H setoids, because we took into account some ideas from the homotopy theory, which is a fine system. In this system, we have that a type should be thought as a space. Hence, we can talk about the homotopy level of a type, and in particular, we focus on two homotopy levels. The first one is the homotopy level equal to minus one, and this is also called the homotopy level of each proposition. The second one is the homotopy level equal to zero, and this is also called the homotopy level of each set. The homotopical intuition behind these two levels is the following. An H proposition is a type which is or empty or contractible. An H set instead is a type which is somehow discrete, which means that all the higher structure is trivial. Okay, so what we did was to define an H setoid as a setoid in which the base type X is an H set and dependent type R is an H proposition. And this is a quite natural choice because what we can do with these two homotopy levels is actually we can do all the set-based mathematics. So our main objective was to study the categorical properties of homotopy setoids. In order to do that, we obtain homotopy setoids as a subcategory of category of setoids. But first of all, let's define the syntactic category ML as the category whose objects are closed types and whose arrows are terms up to functional extensionality. Then we can define the category of setoids whose objects are setoids and whose arrows are functions that preserve the relations. If we restrict to the H sets, we obtain a full subcategory of the category ML, denoted with ML0. And if we restrict to H setoids, we obtain a full subcategory of setoids, which we have denoted with STD0. So our starting point was to observe two main facts about the category of setoids. The first one is that this category is obtained as the exact completion of the syntactic category ML. The second one is that this category is a rich category and it is actually a bi-pretopos or a local, a artificial cause problems. So, starting from these two facts, we aim to prove similar properties for the category of digitoids. So, in particular, we aim to prove that this category is locally Cartesian closed, it is extensive, and it has well-behaved quotients of equivalence relation. But about this last point, we have a problem, which is the fact that now there is a mismatch between the categorical notion of equivalence relation and the type theoretic notion of equivalence relation. And as a consequence, we obtain that the category of HCTOIDs is not exact in the sense of one, and hence it cannot be obtained as an exact completion of a suitable category, as it happened for the category of setoids. So a possible solution is to change framework. And in our case, we chose to work in the framework of the elementary doctrines. The elementary doctrines were introduced by Majetti and Rousseau. They consist of functors from categories with strict finite products into categories of different semantics. You can think about the category C as the level of the context and the values of the functor at the level of the predicates in a suitable context. So the word elementary means that this structure can deal with an equality predicate. And this is required assuming the existence of an element delta in the fiber, so an object times itself for every object x, which satisfies suitable properties, which can be given or a Lalavir as an adjoint property between the fibers, suitable fibers, or equivalently, it can be defined directly providing the core properties of the element delta. For instance, the first property is just the fact that delta is a reflexive relation, and the second one is the property that if we have that a predicate holds on an element x1 and we have that x2 is an element equal to x1, then it happens that the predicate also holds on x2. Well, first of all, let's define two examples coming from factors. So we can define the elementary doctrine FML from the syntactic category ML as a functor which sends a closed type X to the poset of the types depending on X are two logical equivalents. The action of this functor on the arrows of ML is given by substitution, and the elementary structure is given by the identity type. Hence, if we restrict to the H sets and we associate to each H set, the poset of the H proposition depending on that H set, we obtain the elementary doctrine FML0. And the elementary structure is still given by the identity type, which is an H proposition since we are working with H sets. In the language of the elementary doctrines, we can define what is an equivalence relation with respect to a doctrine, and this is the notion of a p-equivalence relation, and we can also define what is a quotient of a p-equivalence relation. And there is this construction provided by Majetti Rosolini, which is called the elementary quotient completion, which associates to each elementary doctrine P, an elementary doctrine P bar, which has well-behaved question with respect to all the P bar equivalence relation. As you see on the screen, the category C bar, which we have to construct in order to provide P bar, looks very similar to the category of setoids. And in a moment, we will see an example coming from setoids. And this construction, the elementary quotient completion, has a universal property stated in terms of an adjunction between the two categories of the elementary doctrines ED and the two categories of the elementary doctrines with well-behaved quotients QED. Okay, so the main examples are given by the category, the elementary doctrines that we have defined previously. In particular, if we take elementary question completion of the elementary doctrines FML and FML0, we obtain two categories which are respectively equivalent to the category of setoids and to the category of H setoids. Hence, we obtain that H setoids are obtained as an elementary quotient completion rather than as an exact completion. And moreover, we know that the elementary quotient completion is to some extent a generalization of the exact completion. Indeed, if we have any quasi left exact category, we can consider the elementary doctrine of Presa Boccia, and the elementary quotient completion of this elementary doctrine gives rise to a category which is equivalent to exact completion. So what we did was to study the elementary the H setoid as an elementary quotient completion, starting from the fact that the elementary quotient completion is a generalization of the exact completion. Hence, we took advantages of theorems about the exact completion, in particular of these two theorems. First one is to Carboni, Rosolini, and Menecker, which characterizes those categories whose exact completion is a locally Cartesian closed category. And the second one is due to Gram and Vitale and characterizes those categories whose exact completion is an extensive category. So what we did was to generalize to the context of the elementary quotient completion this theorem. And the first result that we obtained is a theorem which is the characterization of those elementary doctrines whose elementary quotient completion gives rise to a locally Cartesian closed category. And the same theorem was proved independently by Maietti, Pasquale, and Rosolini. And what happened that our statement and their statement are different, but actually equivalent, because they rely on different notion of weak exponential, which are actually equivalent in this case. The second result that we obtain is a characterization of those elementary doctrines whose elementary quotient completion gives rise to an extensive category. And in order to do that, we had to separate the level of the logic and the level of the context, which are not clearly distinguished in the exact in the case of exact completion. So what we did was to define a notion, the notion of relative pretopos, which is given by an elementary doctrine P with well-behaved quotients, such that the base category is an extensive category. And in this case, we say that C is a pretopos relative to P. Obviously, every pretopos is relative to a suitable elementary doctrine, namely that of some object. And then what we did was to prove that our theorems apply to the case of FML. And hence, we obtained as a corollary that the category of homotopy setoid is a locally Cartesian closed pretopos relative to an elementary quotient completion of FML0. So, our current investigation are focused on those type theories, on finding those type theories that can be modeled in the category of H setoid. And in particular, we are focusing on the type theory with quotient types, intentional or extensional, and on the minimal type theory with quotient types of Maietti and Sami. So this is the end of the talk, and here you have some references. And for any question or comments, please send me an email. And thank you for your attention.